Welcome to a simplified speed run-through of the hypothalamic pituitary adrenal axis. First, a stressful situation is encountered. For example, like this man, you are surrounded by demons and your fish is just a pile of bones. Stressful! The prefrontal cortex will then appraise the situation, and if it is deemed stressful, the HPA axis is initiated. First, the hypothalamus is activated. The hypothalamus then releases CRH, which stands for corticotropin-releasing hormone. Corticotropin-releasing hormone then travels to the pituitary gland, the anterior pituitary gland to be exact. The pituitary gland is easy to recognize because it looks like testicles. The pituitary gland then releases ACTH. ACTH stands for adrenocorticotropic hormone. ACTH travels through the bloodstream to the adrenal glands. The adrenal cortex is then stimulated to release cortisol. Cortisol travels through the bloodstream back to the brain. Glucocorticoid receptors in the hypothalamus and hippocampus are activated. Not the seahorse. The brain part. The brain part is named after the seahorse. This shuts down the release of CRH and ACTH, making this a negative feedback loop. All right, good job. Let's do a review. The hypothalamus releases CRH to the pituitary gland, which releases ACTH to the adrenal gland, which releases cortisol back and stops the negative feedback loop. Hypothalamus, CRH, pituitary gland, ACTH, adrenal gland, cortisol, feedback loop. Bam, done.